Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So in this video, I have included those habits which are not good for hair. So let's get started. So number one is improper cleaning of the scalp. So what is the scalp? It's the skin covering our head, right? And because it's skin, the skin cells constantly dies and regenerate. And why the scalp hygiene is very important? As when the dead cells, sweat, dust, oils, and other particles accumulates on the scalp, itchiness and irritations can happen. And it can affect the overall health of the scalp. A clean scalp can promote a healthy hair growth and that fresh feel. So how will you know that you need to clean your scalp? If you have a tail comb like this, use the tail part to scratch the scalp gently, and if you see white flakes, it's because your scalp is dry. Here, please don't use any harsh shampoos to wash your scalp because it can worsen the condition. So your scalp does need some moisture. So it's good to do a hot oil treatment and then wash off with a gentle shampoo, or even applying aloe vera gel works. So these dry flakes are usually small and white in color, whereas the dandruff is larger and yellow in color. So if you are having dandruff, then use an anti-dandruff shampoo. So number two is lack of oiling your hair. So if you find your hair dry, frizzy or dull, then that might be because of lack of oiling your hair. There are other reasons too that we will discuss later in our video. So what is the easy solution for this? As we know that oil is a very good moisturizer, it can regain the hair moisture. So you can use your regular hair oil. First of all, take some oil, warm it, and then apply this from your scalp to the tip of your hair. Then wash off with a gentle shampoo. Do this regularly until you regain your hair moisture. But if you have severe hair drying issues, then definitely consult a doctor. Number three is choosing a wrong shampoo. Shampoo is basically a hair cleanser. It cleanses the dirt and oil from the scalp, but the pH of the scalp shouldn't be disturbed. First, check whether you have dry, oily, or a normal scalp, then choose accordingly. Always choose a pH balanced shampoo, and also choose a toxin free shampoo. This is one of the best thing you can ever do to your hair. Number four is vigorous rubbing of wet hair. Many people rub the wet hair vigorously with hair towel. Here two things can go wrong. Number one is, if you have a rough hair towel, then it brings more damage to the hair. So opt for a soft hair towel. Number two is, wet hair is already susceptible to breakage and damage. So instead, first squeeze off the water from your hair and then gently pat dry the hair with a soft hair towel. Number five is taking hot water bath. Hot water bath is relaxing, but is it good for your hair? Hot water bath causes the scalp to lose its moisture. Therefore, the hair and the scalp will become dry, frizzy, and is more susceptible to breakage. You can use lukewarm water to shampoo your scalp. And taking bath in normal water is always safe. Number six is combing your wet hair. Many people used to comb their hair faster after hair wash, but this is not a good habit. As when the hair is wet, it can be damaged easily. That is, your hair is weak when it is wet. Instead, you can use the white tooth part of a comb to gently comb your hair. And always try to detangle your hair from the bottom to the up, as it can reduce the hair breakage. Or you can use the white tooth comb to comb your hair, but it should be very gentle. Number 7 is using low quality plastic combs. The quality of the combs definitely matter a lot to the hair. I have seen the change when I stopped using low quality combs. I have noticed that low quality plastic combs made my hair a lot more dry and rough. So these combs are better than the first one. Wooden combs are more beneficial. Number 8 is tying your wet hair. Tying wet hair is not a good idea because it may take too long for the hair to dry and causes more tangle. Another reason is that it can also bring a bad smell to the hair. So after hair wash, leave your hair to dry and then tie your hair. So number 9 is going to bed with the wet hair. As we know that wet hair can be damaged easily. So if you're going to bed with wet hair, double hair breakage can happen along with more tangles. It may smell bad and also seems to be more dull in the morning. So it's good to dry your hair and secure it, and then you can go to sleep. Number 10 is drying your hair regularly with dryer or styling your hair regularly with heat. If you're using hair dryers every day, and that too in a wrong way, can bring a lot of damage to your hair. Try fixing the temperature to medium fast, otherwise your hair can become thin and dull. Please avoid putting it on high temperature as it can damage your hair. First leave your wet hair to half air dry, and then you can use the dryer. You can use these hair styling equipments. But please do not forget to apply the heat protectant and avoid regular usage. Number 11 is tying your hair for a long time. Tying your hair in high pony for a long time can give you headaches. Instead, secure your hair somewhere at a point behind your ear, or it is better to loose braid your hair. Number 12, exposure to sunlight. So it's in the middle of the day, sunlight causes more damage. It's during this time the UV radiation is more. But what will you do if you want to go out? Surely avoid standing out for a long time. When you're going out, always keep a scarf or a hat with you. This will protect your hair. The best way is to take an umbrella with you. This will protect you from the harmful rays of the sun. Number 13 is leaving your hair untied when traveling. If you are traveling and you love sitting on a window seat, but here, hot air mixed with dust can give your tresses dull, dry and tangled look. So secure your hair properly to lock the moisture. Number 14 is helmet hygiene. If you wear helmets daily and you don't care to clean it, then this habit is going to give you hair loss. Check how much dirt is accumulated inside your helmet. Clean it on a regular basis. Number 15, sharing your comb with others. It's good to share things with family and friends, but please don't share your combs and hair towels with anyone, because you may invite fungus or scalp infection through this. Number 16 is hygiene of hair accessories. For example, hair scrunchies, combs, it needs to be regularly cleaned. I have already shared a video on this. Number 17 is pillowcase hygiene. It's good to change your pillowcases weekly, even if you don't have dandruff. Number 18 is hydration. Drinking enough amount of water will make your body hydrated. According to Ayurveda, how much quantity of water one should intake is based on his or her thirst. So drink enough amount of water. Number 19 is stressing yourself. So it's a situation when you are unable to adjust with mental or emotional pressure. This can adversely impact your body. This can cause hair loss. So manage your stress by giving your body proper relaxation. Number 20 is lack of sleep. A quality sleep is very important, as it can reduce the hormones which are responsible for hair loss. Do consult a doctor if you're having severe hair problems. If you find this video helpful, then please subscribe to my channel, and thank you for watching.